We're going to talk about the point-slope form of a linear function, which is a form that we use as a starting point or kind of a stepping stone to get to the slope-intercept form. Let's start with the basics. If we know the slope of a line, m, and we know that it passes through a point, x1, y1, we can use that information to put together an equation for the line, and the form is y equals m x minus x1 plus y1. There's a lot of letters going on there, and it's important to distinguish which ones represent numbers and which ones represent variables. In this case, m is our slope, that's a number. x1 is an x-coordinate, that's a number. And y1 is a y-coordinate, that's a number. The x and y are the variables of our equation, and those are going to stay as variables when we use the point-slope form. Let's see this form in action. Suppose we know a line goes through the point 4, 5 and has a slope of negative 3. We can use the point-slope form to come up with an equation for our line. And what it would look like is y equals m, which is our slope, so that's negative 3. And then in the parentheses, x stays as a variable, minus x1 is 4, plus y1, which is 5. So this would be the point-slope form of our line. In this example, we're asked to find the equation of a line in point-slope form that goes through these two points, negative 4, 8, and 2, negative 2. Well, to use the point-slope form, we need a point and we need a slope. We have an abundance of points here. We have two points to choose from. What we don't have is a slope, but the good news is we can use the slope formula to figure it out. Our slope, m, is going to be y2, negative 2, minus y1, which is 8, over x2, which is 2, minus x1, which is negative 4. So negative 2 minus 8 is negative 10. 2 minus negative 4 is 2 plus 4, which is 6. And that simplifies to negative 5 over 3. Now we're in a position to apply the point-slope form, which is this. Y equals m x minus x1 plus y1. The m we just figured out is negative 5 over 3. So it's going to be y equals negative 5 over 3. Now the x1 and the y1 are supposed to come from the coordinates of a point on the line, but we have two points to choose from. So which one should we use? The good news is it doesn't matter. You can use either one and you will end up with an equivalent equation for your line. So in this case, let's start with the first point, negative 4, 8. In that case, on the inside of the parentheses, we'll have x minus negative 4, and then outside we'll have plus 8. Now this is going to clean up a little bit. Two negatives make a positive, so we have negative 5 over 3, x plus 4 plus 8. There is a point-slope form of the equation. We could just as easily have used the other point, and we would have ended up with an equation that looked different but was equivalent. So let's do that real quick. We'll take our second point here. In that case, the point-slope form would have been y equals m, which is negative 5 over 3, that didn't change, x minus 2 minus 2. This example asks us to find the equation in slope-intercept form from the graph of a linear function. The first thing to point out here is that the y-intercept is not an integer. It's somewhere between 0 and 1, and so we can't just eyeball it. That means that we're going to have to use the point-slope form to come up with some equation for the line, and then we can clean that up into the slope-intercept form. So we need to find two nice points on the line. Well, here's one at negative 4, negative 6. And here is another one at 2, 4. So we have negative 4, negative 6, and 2, comma, 4. We can use these to come up with our equation. First, we can use the slope formula to come up with the slope of our line. That's going to be y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So what happens here? 4 minus negative 6 is 4 plus 6, which is 10. And then 2 minus negative 4 is 2 plus 4, which is 6, which simplifies to 5 over 3. So the slope of this line is positive 5 over 3. Now we apply the point slope form. Y equals 5 over 3 times, again, we can choose either point. I will choose 2 comma 4. And so inside the parentheses, we'll have x minus 2 plus 4. Now, this is the point slope form of the line, but we are asked to find the slope intercept form, which, as you recall, is y equals mx plus b. So we need to take what we have in the point slope form and somehow turn it into the slope intercept form. Well, the way that we do this is by using the distributive property. So we're going to distribute the 5/3 inside the parentheses, and then we will combine like terms to get the final form. So multiplying inside, 5/3 times x is just 5/3 x. And then 5/3 times 2 is 10/3 plus 4. x minus 10/3. 4 is the same as 12 over 3. Negative 10 over 3 plus 12 over 3 is positive 2 over 3. So what we end up with is 5 over 3 x plus 2 over 3. This is the slope-intercept form of our line, but notice that we were given the name f of x for our function, and so we should use that when we report our answer. F of x equals 5 over 3 x plus 2 over 3. Notice that this also confirms our initial suspicion about the y-intercept. We had seen in the graph that it was somewhere between 0 and 1, and now in fact we know that it is 2/3. This example again asks us to find the slope-intercept form of a linear function, but instead of being given a graph, this time we're given a table. But the process is going to be the same. We can find two points and then use the point slope form as a stepping stone to get to the slope-intercept form. As usual, it doesn't matter which two points we pick, and so I'm going to pick this point and this point as my two. And let's write their coordinates down. The first one will be 1, comma, 3. And the second one is 3, comma, negative 2. Now, the first thing we need to do is find the slope between those two points. So we use the slope formula. y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Negative 2 minus 3 is negative 5. 3 minus 1 is 2. So this tells us that the slope of our function is negative 5 over 2. From here, we can go to the point slope form. So we will take negative 5 over 2 as our slope, and I will pick 1 comma 3 as the point that I'm going to use. So plugging into the point slope form, we get y equals m times x minus x1 plus y1. This is the point slope form of the line, which we can now convert into slope intercept by distributing the negative 5 over 2 into the parentheses and then combining like terms. So when we multiply, we end up with y equals negative 5 over 2 times x is negative 5 over 2x. Negative 5 over 2 times negative 1 is positive 5 over 2 plus 3. Now it's just a matter of adding together 5 over 2 plus 3. So we'll rewrite it. 3 is the same as 6 over 2. And now when we add, we end up with y equals negative 5 over 2x plus 11 over 2. Now we have the slope-intercept form of our line, but again, notice we were given a name of our function here, g of x, and so that's what we should report as our answer. G of x equals negative 5 over 2x plus 11 over 2.